All right, first and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shah, Bashem, Rukak, Fadash, double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, who rule well, and who is worthy to be counted for double honors, and peace and salutations to your brothers out there, pushing the truth wholeheartedly and sincerely, and for the love of the gospel. It's the brother Gabar here from Indiana Camp, coming back at you to get one another sit down. So entitled to sit down, beware of false prophets, all right, because this is what you're going to encounter. And at these last days, and more, the more we get close to the kingdom, man, the more false prophets are gonna jump up, even from our roundabouts, man. So people that you wanna believe, you know, will become false prophets, man. You know, as one example is the nigga Nazariah, you know. Fucking Mac the Whack 10, you know, shit like that, man. They're false prophets, man. You know, ISUPK and IUIC, all them niggas are false prophets, man. All right, because they're not teaching what's contrary to the Bible, man. All right, they're not teaching what pertaineth to the scriptures, all right, directly and correctly, man, with edification. All right, so I'm gonna get a couple of scriptures. Lord willing, this video be edifying for you brothers out there. I'm gonna go ahead and get Jeremiah. This is Jeremiah chapter. I'm gonna get Jeremiah chapter 23 starting at verse 16 says, thus said the Lord of hosts, hearken not unto these words of these prophets that prophesy unto you, that make you vain. It says they speak a vision of their own heart. It says what? They make you vain, all right? And how do they make you vain? Because they make you empty, all right? They make you without flesh upon your bones, man. And we're supposed to, and our job as the Lord's pastors, as the Lord's flock, we're supposed to feed the flock, man. We're supposed to build the flock up, man, by putting meat on their bones, by putting a breath in their nostrils, by putting the living water in their belly, man. All right, that's what we're supposed to be doing, man, you know. But these guys out here, these false prophets are going to leave you out here vain, all right. They're going to leave you vain, and they're going to leave you empty, all right. Actually, matter of fact, I think that's in Micah. It's just the Spirit told me to get this. This is Micah chapter 3, verse 3. It says, who also eat the flesh of my people and fillet the skin off of them and break their bones and chop them up in pieces as the pot and the flesh with the cauldron. All right, cauldron. All right, so this is talking about what you false prophets. All right, this is talking about you. Matter of fact, I really should have started from 1. I'm going to start from 1 and then go back to 3. It says, I pray you, O heads of Jacob, says ye princes of the house of Israel, it is not for you to know judgment. All right, because it says what? Matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and get it. I don't even want to quote it. It's lucky. I didn't mean to bring that one up. This is going to be in Psalms. It's lucky. It's going to be in Proverbs, I believe. Yeah. It's going to be Proverbs chapter 28, verse 5. It says, evil men understand not judgment, but they that seek the Lord understand all things. All right. So it says what? It says, oh, you princes of the house of Israel, it is not for you to know judgment. All right. It's talking about you false prophets, because evil men understand not judgment, man. All right. It says, who hate the good and love the evil, who pluck off the skin of them. It says their flesh from off their bones, all right? And we're supposed to be doing what? We're supposed to build the body up. We're supposed to put the flesh back on their bones, man. But these false prophets out here, man, starting from the Christian Baptist Church, is filleting the skin off our people's bones, all right? And it says what? Who also eat the flesh of my people and fillet the skin off of them and break their bones and chop them up in pieces as for the pot, as the flesh within the cauldron. When
Then shall they cry unto the Lord, but he will not hear them. He even hide his face from them at the time, as they have behaved themselves ill in their doings. All right. It says, Thus said the Lord concerning the prophets that make my people err, the bite with the teeth, and cry, peace, and he that putteth not unto them their mouths, they even prepare war against him. All right, because wow, these people, these prophets, if you're calling yourself a prophet, man, you're supposed to what? Y'all say prophesying, man, out here teaching. All right, that's what the prophet's supposed to do, man. You know, warn the people and let the people what's going to notice come to pass, man. But if you're out here not doing that, man, you're a false prophet, all right? It's like you're a false prophet, all right? If you're not out here warning the people, telling what the people's going to come to pass, telling them who they are, who their heritage is, man, then you're a false prophet, man, and the Lord's going to destroy you, man, all right? Go back to that X. No, I didn't have X. Like I had Jeremiah. This is Jeremiah back to Jeremiah 16 verse. It says, they make you vain. They speak as a vision of their own heart and not out of the mouth of the Lord, all right? Now, it says in Deuteronomy, just to show you how would you know a false prophet from a real prophet? This is Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 22. It says, and when a prophet speak in the name of the Lord, so he knows the Lord's name, so what, ISUBK, ITR, the evil Samaritans, all right? It says what? If the thing follow not, nor come to pass, that is the thing which the Lord hath not spoken, but the prophet hath spoken it presumptuously, which also goes to the word proud and assuming. It says what? Thou shalt not be afraid of him. Why? Because he has no power in his words, man. Because he's a false prophet, man. Throughout the scriptures, throughout the ancient world, the prophets was feared, man. Samuel was feared. Elijah was feared, man. You know, the prophets was feared back in the ancient world, man. But these false prophets are not to be feared, man. Because why? They don't have no power in their words. All right. It's going back to the 16 verse. It says, it's like the 17 verse. It says, they say still unto them that despise me, the Lord say, he shall have peace. And they say unto everyone that walketh after the imagination of their own heart, no evil shall come upon you. All right. It says what? No evil shall come upon you, man. So it says what? They're out here preaching peace, the year of life, you know. They're out here saying a whole bunch of madness, man, you know. Talking about the Lord's ain't going to come and destroy America. We still got 50 more years. We still got such amount of years, man. What's these guys talking about, man? You really, a prophet's out there supposed to be warning the people so the people can get ready right with the Lord, man. You out here telling them, oh, no, you're going to be cool, sister. It's all right. It's a year of life. We're going to all come together as Israel. It don't matter what you're going to call the name of the Lord. It don't matter, man. The Lord going to accept you as you is, man. And you prophets, it says in the scriptures, man, who mouths must be stopped, man, because you're going to keep spewing out this madness, man, if your mouths don't be stopped, all right? But it's our job as the real prophets of the Lord to debunk them strongholds, man, all right? It says what? It says, for whom hath stood in the counsel of the Lord and hath perceived and heard his word, who hath marked his words and heard them. All right, so most of these false prophets are going to come that actually was engrafted as real prophets, all right? They were probably once a part of a thing, man, a part of being a man of the Lord, and then the Lord didn't choose them, so they fell out, man. Now they're spewing out madness, man, as the scripture says, man, they was going to do, all right? Everybody has to play their lot, all right? That's all. I want to skip down to verse 21 because I want to get that real good point right here. It says, I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied. See, the Lord hasn't spoken to these prophets. The Lord hasn't dealt with these prophets. But yet, they're so amped and they're so on fire to preach the bullshit that they preach, man. You know? That's why they be spewing out the madness so proudly, man. Because they really think they got something, man. They be like, yeah, man, we got a new breakdown to this. And such, man, they went off on this, man. And we got the true breakdown on it. You know, that's why they be so amped to do it, man. You know? Because they're running, but they're running on their own vain opinion, man. All right? I'm going to get, this is the last one. It says, but if they stood in my counsel and had, and had caused my people to hear my words, then they should have turned from their evil ways and from the evil of their doing. See, so if they really understood the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahshua, they'd have turned from the evil ways, man, and they would have still been preaching the truth, man. All right. I'm gonna get this scripture right here. This is Matthew chapter 7, verse 15. It says, "Beware of false prophets, which shall come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravening wolves." All right, you know, and that's what these false prophets are, man. That's what these these pastors are, man. You know, these idols, man. They come with you in sheep's clothing, acting like they're prophets, but guess what? Inwardly, they're ravening wolves, man. All right. And all the prophets knew all false prophets, man. And they cursed their ass out, man. Just like Stephen did, man. That's going to be the end of the scripture I'm going to get because I don't want to make this video too long. But, yeah, I'm going to just get chopped straight to the point. This is Acts chapter 7, verse 51. It says, "Ye stiff-necked and you uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit, as your fathers did. So ye do, which of the prophets have not your fathers persecuted?" It says, "And they have slain them which slew before the coming of just one, in whom ye have been now a betrayer and murderer." All right. And when Stephen said that, man, people got so fucking heated, man, and mad at him because he was speaking straight truth, man. It says, "Well, who have your fathers not persecuted? Which prophet has your fathers not persecuted, man?" All right, and you look out through all type of these people, man. We always the number one, man. GMS is always the number one. It's always, oh yeah, they going off. You know, they teach about this, they teach about that. Don't follow that sister. We're always being persecuted by these people and their words, man. You know, but it's gonna be coming to a time and point where the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahshua is gonna justify us, man, and plead our cause, man, and destroy these people, man, and show you that these are my faithful and elect, man. You know. And all you people that just jumps on the bandwagon slandering GMS for no specific reason, man, your ass is going to be destroyed too, man. All right? But with that, that's all I want to say, man. Lord willing, I hope this video is edifying for you brothers out there, and the hopeful elect. I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh Shah, Ba'ashem Rukakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone who rule well and who is worthy to be counted for double honors. And peace and salutations to you brothers out there pushing this truth wholeheartedly and sincerely and for the love of the gospel. All right? And with that, shalom.